Next one, classification of tuned amplifiers is classified into small signal tuned amplifier and large signal tuned amplifier. Again, the small signal tuned amplifier classified into different types. First one is single tuned amplifier. So single tuned amplifier is nothing but the the amplifier is tuned at the input or output for a particular frequency. Whereas double-tuned amplifier is tuned at both the input and output of the circuit for a same frequency. The next one is a stagger-tuned amplifier. So stagger-tuned amplifier is nothing but it's also called as a cascade stage of tuned amplifier. That is, the tuned single-tuned amplifier is connected in a more number of stage, where the tuning circuits are tuned to slightly different frequency. For achieving a better bandwidth, wider bandwidth, okay? So, stagger tuned amplifier is nothing but a more number of tuned, single tuned amplifier is connected in a cascade stage and tuned to a slightly different frequency. This is for achieving a wider bandwidth. Whereas, synchronous tuned amplifier is same as the stagger tuned amplifier, but the difference is all the tuning circuits are tuned to the same frequency. That is the difference. So single tuned is again classified into capacitor coupled and transformer or inductively coupled. Double tuned is only inductively coupled. Let's see one by one. So small signal tuned amplifier, it is used to amplify the RF signals of a small magnitude. So single tuned amplifier, it uses one parallel resonance circuit as the load impedance in each stage, and all the tuned circuits are tuned to the same frequency. Okay, so the resonance circuits, that is the tank circuit, is act as a load at each stage. Okay, so more number of amplifier we are using to connect it. So every stage we are using a tank circuit as act as a load at the resonance condition. So all the tuned circuits are tuned to the same frequency. So single tune or capacitor coupled single tune amplifier, it is a basically common emitter voltage biased configuration, where RC is, that is the collector resistance, is replaced by a resonance circuit consists of LNC connected parallel to each other. The parallel network is connected between the collector and VCC. So this is the common emitter amplifier. So in common emitter amplifier, that is the load, that collector resistance is replaced by the tank circuit in a parallel condition, which is connected in a collector and VCC. So function of the component, R1 act as a potential divider providing biasing to the transistors. So the EH component already we know in a common emitter amplifier, right? So RECE provide the thermal stabilization, L and C responsible for selecting the frequency. It is the tank circuit which resonates and made to operate into a resonant frequency, and hence output is amplified version of input. RS is the source resistance, CC is a coupling capacitor. It is used for coupling this stage to the next stage. That is, that CC is a coupling capacitor which is used to coupling the stage to the next stage. So operation, and the high frequency signal to be amplified is given to the input of the amplifier. The resonance frequency of parallel tuned circuit is made equal to the frequency of the signal by varying the value of C. So in a resonance circuit we have a capacitors. By varying this capacitance value, the resonance frequency of the tank circuit is made equal to the frequency of the signal, applying input signal. Under such conditions, the tuned circuit will offer very high impedance to the signal frequency. So when we'll match these two frequency under this condition, the tuned circuit will offer very high impedance out to the signal frequency. Hence, a large output appears across the tuned circuit. In case the input signal is complex containing many frequencies, only that frequency which corresponds to the resonance frequency of the tuned circuit will be amplified. Okay, so by varying the capacitor, we have to generate the frequency, that is called as the resonance frequency. When we'll apply the more number of input signals containing a maximum frequency, many frequencies, only that frequency which corresponds to the resonance frequency, that is that near to the resonance frequency, that type of input frequency only allowed to amplify, right? So the remaining frequencies will be rejected by the tuned circuits. In this way, a tuned amplifier selects and amplifies the desired frequency. So this is the equivalent circuit of that single tuned amplifier circuits. So this is a modified diagram. This one is a simplified diagram for the calculation purpose, right? So modified equivalent circuit by applying Miller's theorem. So Miller's theorem, because here we are using a RBC, which is the feedback, is common to collector and base. So both input as well as output, this is the Miller's components. By applying the Miller's theorem, which is common to both input as well as output, so that's why here we are using a simplified circuit diagram, or B dash E is parallel with capacitance, and here is series with resistance. So A is the voltage gain of the amplifier, C1, C2 are the stray wiring capacitance in the input-output circuit, Cs is the input capacitance grouped together. So Cs is equal to, the total input capacitance Cs equal to Cb dash E plus C1 plus Cb dash E into 1 minus A. Okay, so Cs is a group of the all capacitance. So C is equal to Cb dash E, A minus 1 by A plus C2 plus C dash. Cge is a 1 by RCe. So these are all used for the derivation purpose. We will just note on this one. The admittance of the inductor along with resistor R is given by YI equal to 1 by R plus J omega L, right? So now R, multiply numerator and denominator with R minus J omega L, then we get this equation. Simplification, we finally get this one. So now separately to write real term as well as imaginary term. So which is nothing but we have to assume that RP is this one and LP is this one. So the Q of the coil at resonance is given by, we know already formula, Q equal to omega L by R, where omega not equal to 1 by root LC is the frequency of resonance circuits, because we know F is equal to 1 by 2 pi LC. So omega not is nothing but 2 pi F. So from that we can write omega not equal to 1 by root LC. So RP is equal to R square plus omega square L square by R. Now replace omega equal to, that is R commonly taken. So R plus omega square L square R divided by R. Then only these two are cancelled. So we get this term divided by R. R are cancelled. So R is small when compared to this term. So we can neglect this R value. So finally, RP equal to omega not omega square L square by R. RP is equal to omega square L square by R. So likewise, because of Q naught of the coil is widely, so we can neglect this R value. Finally, we get RB this. Similarly, LP equal to R squared omega squared L squared by omega squared L squared. So here, divide by omega squared L and both numerator and denominator. So R squared by omega squared L plus omega squared L squared by omega squared L, omega squared L by omega squared L. These two cancel. So R squared by omega squared L plus L by 1. So when compared to this, we can neglect this term, R value, R is small, so we can neglect this term. So LP equal to L. So the output circuit of the amplifier can be modified as this LP and RP, R naught, RI. So taking RT as the parallel combination, so 1 by RT equal to 1 by R naught plus 1 by RP plus 1 by RI. So the output circuit is finally CL and RT. Total resistance is nothing but this one. The effective